gentlemen, welcome to tonight's featured match between the Example National and your DME National Team. Introducing the starting lineups. First, for the visitors from Example National, number one, Shania James. Number 11, Ariana Williams. Number 12, Mia Zanere. Number 13, Noelani Dunn. Number 42, Roxy Light. Example, coached by Barry Bradford. And now for the ladies from DME. Number 1, Nez Bordova. Number 3, Olivia Schmidt. Number 12, Tabitha Besson. Number 30, Taj Bloom. Number 33, Kiara Scott. DME's head coach. Mike Panaggio, assistant Anthony Robertson and Tia McMillan. Good to all the teams tonight. Let the league begin.
Well, we have arrived at tonight's final matchup, and it is a matchup worthy of a heavyweight title bout. Two teams ranked in the top 10 of the ESPN rankings and the Max Prep rankings. DME against Example National. Terrence, here we go.
On paper, it seems to be a good matchup, but looking on the court, I think right now, looking, there's only five players on the court. Well, there will be five players on the court and three players on the bench, for Example National. So DME is looking deep on the depth chart. So I'm not sure how this game is going to play out with Example National, but I do see favorites to DME right now.
Example National in the pink. They win the tip. They'll go to the right. DME in the black and blue. They'll defend and go to the left. Immediately, Ines Goriova tries to pick the pocket of Noelani Dunn. Around the top, here's Roxy White. White gets to the bait line against Betson. Throws it back to the top, finds a shoot. White underneath. Betson swallows her up, and the shot hits the bottom of the backboard. And last game, we talked about the guard play.
Right.
This game, it's all about going to be about DME's forwards. Taj Bloom and Tabitha Betson committed to Mississippi State and Colorado, respectively, in the front court.
I hear you, Mike. It's going to be about the fours, but I think it's going to be all about number 33, Kiara Scott, today, the Syracuse commit. She looked good in warm-ups. You know who also looked good to me in warm-ups? Olivia Smith. She was dead on. Didn't miss a three-pointer. So we'll see how that translates during
this game.
First
foul of the game goes against Example. With only eight players on their roster, you got to be careful picking up those early fouls.
That's what I said at the beginning. That's why I think advantage goes to DME, but we'll see.
Tapped away by Mia Zanair in New Lenox, Illinois. Current team captain for Example Academy. DME first offensive possession. Open look from the wing. A little bit too strong. And then fighting through contact to get the offensive rebound is Taj Bloom, and she'll get the foul as well.
That was a nice shot by Kiara Scott on that play. She just couldn't get it to fall. And we're back in action.
Bloom looking for the kick out. Baseline drive, Schmidt.
Good pass by Schmidt. Bloom just couldn't get a handle on it.
Example goes coast to coast, and it's blocked. Kiara Scott got a hand on it, and she can't finish on the other end, and she runs into the base of the basket.
The basket is undefeated.
Backdoor pass, Roxy White opens the scoring for Example.
For everybody, quicker score than we've seen in the last two previous games, Mike, so
yeah.
That offense is getting started early as Example presses DME.
And they get the steal and the score from Noelani Dunn.
And they're still in their half-court press, in their full-court press offense, defense, excuse me.
And they get another steal, and they're gonna get another possession as the ball comes off of Schmidt.
You see that press defense, like I said, the first game, a lot in high school basketball, and right now it's kind of being like a thorn in the side of DME. Let's see if they can get through it.
All right, now they gotta play defense against a downhill attack from Ariana Williams. Hand off. Three. is short from Noelani Dunn. Dunn has some offers, Evansville and George Mason at the Division I level. And they're going to stay in that full court press. DME has been unable to break it so far. The double team comes. It's shuffled into the front court. Betson has it. Backdoor pass. Kira Scott mishandled it. Has to come back to the corner to grab it. Schmidt up on top, guarded closely by Shania James. Throws it high post to Betson, the native of Australia. Gets it back. Jumps through the lane and then throws it away to Roxy White of Example. Example. Options on offense. And White finds Dunn for the land.
It would be a good time for Mike Panaggio to take a timeout here to try and settle this thing down before it gets too out of hand.
6-0 early Example. And it's going over. The native of Sofia, Bulgaria has the ball now. Catch and shoot. From the screen and three. And DME is in the game. Olivia Schmidt rattles down the triple. Schmidt from Staten Island, New York, and is going back to the state of New York for college. She'll play at Syracuse along with her teammate, Kira Scott. Example throws the ball into the corner. This is Shania James, who walks it back to the wing. Left-hand drive, throws it to the opposite wing. Fake the pass, step inside, take the long two, and miss it from Mia Zaire. And it's going to be DME ball.
Mike, who did you say was committed to George Mason?
Not a commit, but an offer from George to Noelani Dunn of George Mason.
That's Coach Vanessa Blair Lewis up there.
Yep, former Bethune-Cookman head basketball coach. Extra pass, Betson open for three.
Bang!
It's good, and that is a power forward triple.
And just like that, DME is back.
We talked about the forwards, Bloom and Betson, as there's an example prep player down, and we'll take a quick timeout. She hops back up. As Ariana Williams gets applause from the crowd. You can't see it because it's all below the camera, but there's a decently big crowd down there on the bottom floor.
Mike, those are DME basketball players over there clapping. I think they're being funny. I don't think they're too hard.
Well, despite the fact that there are DME basketball players in the building, there are also plenty of scouts in the building. No less than four D1 schools represented, including Notre Dame from shirts and polos down there.
That's amazing. Like you said, two powerhouses in the top of the country going at it, number five and number eight.
That'll be a defensive foul. Coach Panaggio looking for a charge, won't get it.
You would expect to see plenty of scouts in the building for a game like this. Plus, it's Christmas time, Mike. It's the Jingle Jam.
And everybody wants to come to Florida during the holidays. If I'm a scout. As the first free throw is hit by James. If I'm a scout.
You're a scout.
And there's a tournament happening in Florida, and I'm, you know, from Notre Dame or Southern Illinois.
Yeah.
Send me down to Florida.
Wait, bring the sunscreen.
Even though the weather hasn't been the best by our standards this week, it's still a lot better than most of the rest of the country. Catch and shoot. Almost a third straight three for DME. Offensive board, Betson, hook shot, doesn't go.
I told you I was looking for Scott to do some big things this game, and she's pulling that trigger early.
Example goes with tempo. Step back mid-range jumper from the baseline won't go. As this game has some frantic energy to it early on. Just a quick pull-up from Ennis Goranova. Space to take the shot and make the shot for Trinity. Cheers. Only a 2-point basket. It is 10-6. Cheers from South Holland, Illinois. Scored a team high 18 points in the loss to Montverde Academy early on. Here's a three from the wing. Dagger!
I told you.
Olivia Schmidt has her second three of the first quarter.
Dead on doing the warm-up.
So DME is coming out and just trying to shoot the long ball. That's all they've done. Example, and there's another reach-in foul against DME. It's going to go against Goranova. Example has kind of spread the ball out a little bit, going into the post sometimes, taking some mid-range shots, taking some deep shots. But it's been all about the three. All nine of DME's points.
I was about to say, not for DME. It's been all about the three. for DME, and I told you during warm-up, Olivia Smith was dead on. She was locked in.
There's a three from Example. Too strong, but the ladies in pink grab the board through Trinity Cheers. Cheers drives, puts it up, no good. Another offensive board. That time for Roxy White. Block on the inside, Betson. Scott in transition, pulls up, tucks it down.
Mike, that's too good. That's too good.
DME has the lead 11-10. A rip-roaring first quarter as only 2.5 minutes to go in it. Baseline jumper, too strong.
An example is they're having some good looks and they're being really
and
good
lots
basket.
Of second chance opportunities, for example. There's not a lot of boxing out going on DME's side.
Nah, good basket by Roxy White, being able to get that rebound and put it right back up and get those points. DME is within one right now with 2 minutes and 10 seconds left to go in the first quarter.
And again, it's high man-to-man pressure from Example Prep, but they didn't cover the corner. That's a little bit too strong. The rebound comes out towards Kira Scott, but it's bounced forward to White. Roxy White, step through in transition, no good. The shortest player on the floor, Olivia Smith, grabs the board. And then all alone at the other end is Goranova.
Easy buckets by Goranova, and the DME faithful are going crazy on the sideline.
Olivia Smith, just 5'5", but can shoot the lights out of the gym.
They're going to have to turn these lights out after she gets done on this court. You're right.
High pick and roll action.
Good job.
And Samora Damon flashes through for the bucket.
Now, this is an offensive matchup that we've been waiting for all night, man.
Both teams showing what they're made of. That time a defensive stop as Damon pokes it away from Betson. Smith, Eurostep, no good. Offensive board foul.
That was Smith on the defense, though. Good job. Getting back to the other end of the court.
Let's see who they get for the foul. Goranova picks up her second. Long afternoon of commentating. Really good basketball.
Absolutely. Absolutely. I'm excited for the weekend. We have a weekend filled with basketball. Some of the matchups tomorrow are even better than the matchups today.
Run you through those matchups as we go through the day. And of course, three games on Saturday as well here at the league. 2-for-2 from the line for White. And Example National holds a 16-13 lead with a minute to go in the first. Olivia Schmidt, the Syracuse commit. New York High School State champion as well.
So and
SIAA Player of the Year.
She's going back home for college.
Scott, catch and shoot off the weave, and she knocks it down.
I can't say I told you so no more, Mike.
No, you can't. 1 point game, 38 seconds to go first quarter. This feels like the end of the game.
Right, it does. And we just started.
Batted out of bounds, and Schmidt getting it done on the defensive side. Again, listed at just 5'5".
With a rejection.
With the rejection. 30 seconds left. Ball goes in. Cheers. She'll run the offense with her heels almost on the time stripe. Corner jumper. No good. Boxing out for the rebound is DME and the reach-in foul as well. Foul's going to go against Adrena Gordon. Gordon, the native of Ohio, played at St. Vincent St. Mary High School.
Oh, really?
Home of one LeBron James.
Not LeBron James High School. Good program up there, St. Vincent St. Mary.
Nice touch pass from Betson to the corner, and it's another triple for DME, this time from Barnes.
And that's the end. Pull-up shot, no good.
DME hits 4 3-pointers in the first quarter, and they lead 18-16 over a very game Example National team. Again, we feel like we've played 40 minutes and it's only been 8.
Right, and like you said, this Example National team has been through the fire already with the first five ball games already.
Yeah, they're 3-4, but their losses are to IMG,
right.
Spire Academy, Montverde Academy, and Presswood, the reigning Canadian champions.
And we definitely know IMG and Montverde always bring it. DME actually plays Montverde February 22nd here in DME, so that's going to be an interesting game. So Example National, they've already been through the fire, and they're still ranked number 8 in the country with a record of 3-4.
And the number 1 strength of schedule as well.
That's good. That's going to pay off for them down in the line, down the line in the league.
The third year all-girls prep program based in the Chicago area, Example National. They're playing with a younger roster this year, only 3 seniors. That's because 9 seniors graduated last season. They're all playing Division I ball right now, with 3 of them playing Power 5. Lisa Thompson with Rutgers, Jasmine Brown with Mississippi State, and Denise Johnson with Iowa.
That's a good track record to have, especially when you can have a program that sends 9 seniors out and all of those seniors get scholarships to go to the program. That's a heck of a basketball program there.
Gets it. Down the edge. Backing up into a 3. And it's good again. Asa Barnes, her second triple. She hit one right at the end of the first. She gets one right at the beginning of the second.
Slicing the net.
DME getting that home court advantage. They get the turnover as well. Nice defense that time by Cheyenne Preston, the hometown girl from Sanford.
It's nice to see the hometown kids, you know, get their due.
Especially at a powerhouse program like this, you've got players from all over the world, and somebody from right here in Central Florida is making their way.
Ooh,
nice
good pass.
Extra pass.
Good pass.
Schmidt to Scott.
To who?
To Scott.
To Scott.
6 points already for Kira Scott in the ball game, and all of them on easy layups. They'll run the high ball screen weave. Falling down, missing the shot is Damon. In transition, they're looking for Scott.
Ooh.
And that's a double
they
deflection
twice.
By Sanaya James. She made the first deflection and the second deflection. That's great defense.
That is great defense. Laura Barnes in the corner has been absolutely phenomenal.
And Shania James gets the steal, and she waits for the defender to go by and score. That's a terrific 30 seconds for Shania James.
That's
2 deflections on defense, a steal, and
a score.
Yeah. 23-18, DME in the lead right now.
But still, Example came into play.
Oh, the fake pass! Olivia Schmitz! That was insane!
I almost fell out the chair.
The fake pass took 2 defenders out the play. They both. And there was a foul.
Mike.
And a foul.
This is the lead. Awesome basketball.
Timeout on the floor. And you can see Barry Bradford, the Example coach, not happy with his team's. I mean, you can't fault the effort, right?
Mm-hmm.
But I think they have to guard the 3-point line.
They do.
They have to close out to the 3-point line because DME will burn you.
Hey, like I said, Laura Barnes is burning them right now. She's setting that net on fire, and they can't get to it. And Kiara Scott is doing what she's supposed to do, as well as Olivia Smith is distributing the ball. DME is on fire right now. But Example National, they're right there.
Yeah.
DME is pulling away slowly, but Example is right there, but you would expect them to pull away as the game goes on. They only have 3 reserves.
Yeah, well, also, Example National is playing a very, very close press man defense. It's almost like a full court press, but they're sticking right with their man, trying to jump those passing lanes, trying to turn the ball over, and I think that's going to play to their detriment the longer this game goes on if DME can wear them down.
Right, because they're not going to be able to cover everybody that long.
Because if you're switching every interaction, if somebody misses, oh, look, there's someone open
someone
for
3
or someone open in the paint.
Good move.
That's a great
that's
move
a great
by
move.
Trinity Cheers. Her first bucket of the second quarter, second overall. 5-point game. need to get in the front court. She does. And another no-look pass and another easy bucket for Scott. And that was Schmidt again.
It was.
Facilitator and can knock it down.
And guess what?
They're going to the same college.
Yes. A little preview there for your Syracuse fans.
Right.
Illegal screen. DME ball.
Shania James
picks up her second foul. And that's something we are going to watch closely, right, with only eight players on the roster.
Especially this early in the game. She picked up two, and right now she usually would be going to the bench for a substitution, but I don't think they could do that right now.
Schmidt gets a nice screen. Is that an offensive foul? No, it's a block.
Blocking
and
foul.
She'll go to the line. You could tell that James had just dragged your foot through the restricted area. That's why it's not.
And still right now, Mike, all day, third game, no charge. Well, no charges were called.
And there really hasn't been a need for one.
Right.
First, hey, can you believe this is the first trip to the line tonight for DME at all?
And also the first substitution of the night, for example, National.
Schmidt hits them both. Schmidt up to 10. There's 5 minutes left in the first half. Already double figures. Tiptoeing the out-of-bounds line is done. Extra pass into the corner. Baseline run. That's a tough shot. It hangs on the rim and goes in.
And let me tell you, it excellent shot because Betson was right there ready to eat that ball alive.
Trinity Cheers is kind of taking over, for example, National on offense. But she's up to 6 points. Betson, top of the key, loses the handle, chases after it, shovels it over to Schmidt. Schmidt. Round a screen. Kira Scott for three. Ooh, way off.
Yeah,
and that is why you kind of want your forward in the paint and not out shooting three.
Listen, I'm a big man, right? So every once in a while when I play it, I want to take that shot. You got to let the big people live, man.
Betson, Bloom, and Kira Scott, a dynamite combo in the front court for DME. That's going to be a trip to the line for Trinity Cheers as Example Prep has decided to just let the whole offense run through her. Schmidt picks up her first foul. Oh, no, it was not a shooting foul, so it's just an inbounds.
The ball out of bounds, looks like it's going to go back. DME.
And it is going to be off of Roxy White. White just picked up an offer from Ohio State recently. In the last couple of weeks, also has offers from Western Georgia, Loyola Chicago, and Purdue Fort Wayne.
Oh, wow. Okay.
High post. Here's Preston. Into the corner.
It
Scott
is. Yes,
attacks
is.
The closeout. Ooh. Can't hit the mid-range jumper, and it goes out of bounds. And that's a shot that Scott has hit in this game.
It is, and her friends are giving her a hard time on the sideline. They were saying, that's two.
Example really slowing this one down now as they cross the time stripe with just 5 seconds left before the penalty.
Ball's going to be off the leg of Example. National is going to be going back the other way to DME.
Noah Lonnie Dunn just dribbled it off her foot.
Mm-hmm.
Unforced errors. You can't have them in a game like this.
You can't. And Kiara Scott's going to come out of the game right now. Maybe she needs a little breather after missing those two shots.
Well, and again, DME hasn't really substituted at all
right.
in this game. I'd love to see Betson try and get some work down low. She's been
up top
facilitating. Catch and shoot from way downtown. That's too strong.
Which should be the game plan because they
again
look outside.
Again, it's dribbled off a foot. DME takes the ball. Coast to coast, kick out. Goranova step through, a triple off the front of the rim, and you can tell she didn't really get her full body weight on.
Yep.
Step back between the legs, and Cheers almost missed everything. And that's a pass to nowhere, picked off by Damon. Racing into the front court, tried to find the pass for the easy layup. DME takes it away.
Three
this game
one.
Is being played at a frantic pace. And Barnes puts it in.
Laura Barnes.
2:55 to go. It sometimes it felt like the first two games were took a while.
Right, this one got right out the gate.
I mean, this game, we feels like we've been commentating for 5 minutes, and it's already the,
it's almost halftime.
Almost halftime.
It's almost halftime. But don't you love those games? Never a dull moment.
No, it isn't. And that ball is tapped out of bounds by Taj Bloom, the native of Chicago, Illinois. She's taken her talents to Mississippi State. Listen to the schools that she picked Mississippi State over. Arizona, Ohio State, Miami, Clemson, Minnesota, Michigan, Illinois, Kentucky, Tennessee, and Maryland.
It must be something in Mississippi. It must be something in the water in Mississippi that got her over there to be a Bulldog.
And just as I was praising, she picks up a foul.
I told you. You got to check those rules.
The front court for DME, especially defensively, has been a real problem. For example, prep right now. And they're going to get Bloom, I think, for a hold. And they are. That's her second foul in as many seconds. And no, there was just a 30 on the shot clock, not 30 for a foul, my bad.
Yeah, no, and she it was a kickball.
31-22, DME leads Example National. White into the corner, done. Corner to corner, rattles out. Every rebound is a battle.
Here's a good.
Long pass. Back to the top, Goranova, hesitation, drive into the trees and draws the foul.
And everybody in the stands almost expected Laura Barnes to pull up for that three-pointer. Everybody stood up.
Especially after the cross-court. We get a big cheer for the guy sweeping the floor. I think he plays for the DME boys team.
He did.
He's hearing it from his
He did a horrible job. That's why they got to call him back out.
But, yeah, you're right. I did expect Barnes to pull up
right
after that cross-court pass.
Everybody in the gym did.
She just kind of slowed it down, let the offense get set.
Yeah, everybody stood up because they were expecting her to pull that trigger.
Bloom throws it down low, picked off by Damon. Whistle and a stoppage of play. And Coach Panaggio not happy about something. Probably the pass that was
picked
off.
Yeah.
Especially because if you're in that position at around the nail,
right,
you shovel that ball down there, you got to see that your player has position, and she didn't have position. I think it was a shot clock issue is why we're restarting this possession.
I couldn't see what happened or what was going on.
And Example Prep is not happy because they had a odd man rush, coined a phrase from hockey, and was denied by the shot clock not working.
And they still haven't gotten the score. They're really slowing down the momentum right now.
31-22. I mean, it gives us a chance to catch our breath a little bit.
I don't want to catch my breath, man. This is the lead.
And this has been the best half of basketball we've seen today. Fast-paced, great skill, very competitive. Roxy White too strong on the mid-range. And you know what Example National started in? Got out to a big 6-0 lead and then stopped? Full court press.
Right.
They went away from the full court press. Barnes attacks the closeout. Gets it underneath. Tries to reverse. It gets blocked by Roxy White. White wanted to travel as well, but not going to happen. 13 on the shot clock here. 1:19 to go in the first half. Timeout DME.
Do you see Mike Panaggio on the court?
He
wants a full timeout.
He's
going to let it be known.
He coaches with so much energy. We saw before we went on the air, there was some other Jingle Jam games, the junior varsity games earlier today. We saw some coaches that would just sit on the bench, talk to the assistant coach, talk to the players on the bench.
No, Mike was everywhere.
Mike
and he was up here with us.
Is not that person.
Not at all. Not at all, but I love it. You got to love to see it. You got to have, in order to have passionate players, you have to have passionate coaches. You because the players a lot of times take on the personality of the coaches, as they say. It is absolutely true, Mike. So I like to see that passion because that means the player is going to be passionate as well.
DME Academy 10-0. And it's not like they've played nobody. Powerhouse out of Canada, St. Francois, Bishop Kenny, Sarasota, and Dr. Phillips, Cardinal Mooney, American Heritage, all powerhouse programs here in the state of Florida. TPLS Academy and Sparta, other academies from around the country. They've beat them all, and they beat them all convincingly.
Well,
the closest game was a 55-49 overtime win against Dr. Phillips.
Say that score again.
55-49.
In overtime.
In overtime. Okay. Low scoring game. We might,
I was going to say, we're going to touch that here.
We might get there in the first half. Not quite. But, nice move.
Ooh, she just couldn't finish it.
Yeah.
There was no foul there.
Bloom could not hit the shot. She was wide open, and then Betson and Damon go crashing to the ground.
And Damon fell on her own. I didn't see anybody pull her down.
Betson checks out, and Kira Scott checks back in.
She did fall kind of awkwardly, but it was off of one of her teammates.
Yeah, there was no foul. Ball just went out. As Noelani Duns walks up the floor. 1 minute to go in the first half. 31-22, DME the lead. They've done it with a three-point shot. And, whoa. Okay, so it's not. They get the foul on Schmidt.
That's her second.
Bloom was protesting her innocence, and I was about to jump to her rescue because she did not touch Roxy White at all. But they got it from the player reaching on the backside.
Calm down, Mike. Calm down. Actually, it's been good officiating today.
Yo, in all three games. Take a three. Miss a three.
Ooh.
From Adrina Gordon. Nice move in the middle of the floor to get free from DME. Behind the back, Goranova, into the corner, extra pass, short corner.
There we go.
Open for three, Barnes.
Bang!
It's good. Laura Barnes, 8 points in the second quarter for Barnes. 34-22 DME. And in a game like this, Terrence, it doesn't matter what the score is. We could see a massive comeback from
Example
National, and I wouldn't be surprised at all.
Right, especially if DME doesn't keep their foot on the gas pedal. Like we said, Example
seconds.
National was doing a good job with that four-court press.
And now they use the press to turn the ball over. Two on one the other way. And that's a foul against Taj Bloom. And this time I'm not going to come to her defense like I was before. She did it.
34-22 with 3.4 seconds left to go in the half. Like you said, Mike, this game is flying.
Wide open. Yeah.
They are wide open.
Yeah.
They are. And it's good to see. It's good for the league.
And we've seen half-court defensive basketball in the first two games, especially that second game. Everybody, if there's a rebound, if there's a steal, if there's any sort of deflection, they're running. They're running down to try and catch an outlet pass the other direction. Damon makes the first the line.
And Gerard comes into the game for the first day, and Roxy White for the first time today, and Roxy White is back in the game.
It's both 3.4 to go. Wouldn't be surprised if DMA just takes this to the half. And they will. 34-24. A 10-point DME lead at the half. This game has been wild and probably will continue to be so tense.
I think it is going to be wild, and I think it's going to be a wilder finish. And I'm excited to be a part of it. I'm excited to see it. And I'm excited for this halftime show. I forgot that we had the baton twirling girl coming in.
Enjoy the halftime show. I'm sure we will too. We'll step aside for about 10 minutes. And when we come back, it's the second half between DME and Example National. It's the end of day one of the league. Don't go anywhere.
Ladies and gentlemen, please direct your attention to center court. Kimber Amadeo, a national champion for Twan Curling, is a junior at DME. He plans to join the Gatorettes at the University of Florida upon graduation. Let's give a big warm welcome to Kimber.
Thank you.
Welcome back to the campus of DME Sports Academy in Daytona Beach, Florida.
D-Town.
To the League Daytona, presented by the National Athletic Association of Independent Schools. We've got our final half of the night coming up. Currently, it's DME 34, Example National 24.
It's a bittersweet moment right now because, of course, you know, you want the night to end because you want to go home and go snuggle in the bed. But I absolutely do not want this matchup to end. DME versus Example National has been electrifying since tip-off.
Now let me get to some of those electrifying numbers. First, for Example, James has 4, Damon has 4, Dunn has 4, and Shears and White all have 6. Very balanced score, scoring
balanced
attack, for Example. Less so for DME.
Let's go, Mike.
Barnes has 11.
Bang.
Schmidt has 10.
Bang, bang.
Scott has 8. Betson, just 3. And that's it.
That's it. Lopsided. Barnes has been the trigger woman tonight for DME. Every time she pulls up from the three, everybody in the gym stands up.
Yeah. DME's hit 6 threes. 3 of them have been from Barnes.
Remember we started off, DME was losing 6-0. Was it 6-0 or
9-0? It was
8-0. 8-0.
Yeah.
And then they
started hitting the 3.
No.
That's what changed.
Barnes started hitting the 3.
Well, it was Schmidt first.
And then the onslaught.
Barnes started hitting the 2. But then, as the second quarter progressed, you saw Example National claw back in because they started attacking the 3-point shot, forcing them to a dribble attack instead of pull up on the closeout, right?
And initially in the beginning of the game, they were at that four-court press, and it was giving DME fits. So let's see if they come back out and go back into that. Down by 10 right now.
And they never went back to it. They showed flashes of it here and there, maybe just like to try and trap against the midcourt line, but they never went fully into that full-court press that got them that 8-0 lead at the beginning of the game.
But you know what it is, Mike? You ever been in a situation where you can't see because you're in the situation, but you're not in it, and you have all the advice? So that's kind of what's going on right now. I don't think they can see that was working out for them in the beginning, but us from the outside looking in.
Well, yeah, it's hard to have a 1,000-foot view when you're standing on the ground.
Absolutely, and we have that 1,000-foot view.
Up top. 30-foot.
30? It was about 30, yeah.
Here we go. Example National in the pink. DME Academy in the black. Get ready for another exhilarating half of basketball that comes to you right now.
And we switch in.
Final half of day one of the lead. 3-pointer from straight on, no good from Zenaire to start the second half. This is electric in the first half with Olivia Schmidt. Goranova still looking for her first bucket. The tip pass comes back to Schmidt. And then it goes to the legs of Goranova, stays in play. Example with a 2-on-1 the other way. And the layup is no good.
Got to capitalize on that to call back into this game.
Goranova throws it up to Betson all the way out. Catch and shoot triple, just a little bit short. Ooh. From Olivia Schmidt. And then Dunn crashes to the ground on the baseline. It'll be Example National ball.
Taj Bloom actually ran into her accidentally. She couldn't stop. That's her third foul of the evening. She should be checking out, and she is checking out of the ball game right now.
Laura Barnes checks back in. A game-high 11 points for her. Originally from Tampa, Florida, but has Turkish descent and played for them at the U16 Women's European Championship this year.
That's interesting. Some of these kids have lived full lives at the age of 16.
And Goranova, I think, got an elbow to the face from Shania James, inadvertent, but she is still holding her face a little bit. That rip move, where you rip the ball from low to high to try and get the defender to jump back. You got to be careful because sometimes you can catch somebody in the face. There is an example national player over there on crutches.
Yeah, it is. I can't see her number.
I believe it's Samora Damon. No, it's Ariana Williams. Anyway, Betson runs in, and we've got our first charge as Betson runs over Zanair.
And see, according to the announcer Jinx rule, that means I would get flagged on this game because I mentioned it.
Betson picks up her third foul. It's not been a banner day for the senior forward out of Melbourne, Australia, who's headed to Colorado next year.
So you have Betson in foul trouble already.
Well, Betson, a little bit of redemption there as she gets the block on Zanair.
Betson and Bloom are in foul trouble early.
And that's tough for a DME team that relies so much on that front court. 5 second violation as Cheers couldn't get the ball in. Second one of those we've seen today, Tim.
Right.
And now here comes the full court press.
They're back at it again. Let's see if DME can get it across the court, and they do.
Goranova unfazed by that shot to the face. Betson, top of the key, doesn't take this shot. Extra pass, Goranova catch and shoot. Drops it in the bucket.
She got him.
Goranova got her first points of the game with three.
Ines Goranova from Sofia, Bulgaria, but played AAU ball in New York, and she's in the ESPNW top 100 prospects in the nation. Nice
good
spin
ball
move.
Movement and good
reverse
spin.
Layup by Damon won't go. In transition, extra pass to the corner. Baseline drive for DME. That's a wild pass.
She didn't look over, but she was getting run out of bounds, so she just did what she could.
Mid-range jump shot. These possessions aren't lasting more than 5-10 seconds. Both teams just immediately looking to shoot after one or two passes. Like that.
Bang!
It's another drop in the bucket. Lara Barnes, her fourth three of the game. Timeout, DME.
And Mikey Panaggio off the bench, on the court, slapping his players up, excited about it.
Listen, if I'm a coach, yes, you're up 40 to 24, but I can't be fully happy with the way the team is playing right now. They're playing very selfish, taking a shot after just one or two passes. Possessions are not being extended for even not even close to the full 30 seconds. That's okay if you're behind. If you're ahead, even just in the third quarter, you've got to start extending those possessions and shortening the game.
Mike, you sound like the purple one's mother right now. Maybe I'm just like my mother. Maybe I'm never satisfied. Look at the game. We're in a jingle jam, Mike. Let's have some fun. I get it, though. I get exactly what you're saying. They should extend the possession. But this, right now, Mike, is a shootout.
Yeah.
And it's for the fans.
And DME is winning that shootout, obviously, because they hit all the threes. There have been no three-pointers in the game hit by example prep. They also haven't scored yet in the third quarter.
Hey, Mike, guess what? This is the lead.
Very exciting basketball right now for everybody watching.
Yeah. If you like run-and-gun basketball, you're loving this right now.
You don't like running gun basketball.
There's a time and a place.
This isn't the time or place.
If you're up 40 to 24.
Thank you, Mike.
Fakes the three, does Damon, steps all the way back and resets.
So, Mike, you say slow it down because you're up big.
And foul. They're going to get a hold off the ball against Goranova. That'll be her third foul. So, DME in a little bit of foul trouble. Goranova has three. Betson has three. Bloom has two.
Definitely slow it down now and get out of here.
And even though you do have the deeper bench than example, here comes the hard press to try and force the backcourt violation. Gordon works out of it. Gordon driving, kicking. Roxy White in the corner, knocks it down. The first three of the ball game for Example Prep.
I was just about to congratulate Kiara Scott on defense. Mentally, I was thinking it, and then Roxy White shot the three-pointer.
Schmidt gets it back from Betson. Nice job on defense by Gordon to deny the drive, and then it's tapped out of bounds. It'll be still DME ball as it went off of Roxy White.
Good pass by Schmidt getting it back over there to Betson. She wasn't able to hold on to it as she was trying to make the extra pass to get over.
Yeah. As I said, not a banner day on offense for Betson. I think just three points.
Yeah, not at all. But.
And has a couple of turnovers. That time DME does get the ball in. Extra pass.
It is.
It's a wing three. It's another wing three. Guess who? Laura Barnes. Wow, because that possession initially was a little bit confusing to me because Goranova had a free lane to the basket for a layup. But why take 2 points when you can kick it out to the hottest shooter in the building?
Especially when she's on fire. Come on.
Is that a travel or is that a foul? It's a travel.
DME basketball.
It goes against Adrina Gordon. Gordon, basketball in the blood. Her sister is an assistant coach for the women's basketball team at Division I Northern Illinois. It's Barnes again.
Bang!
Again!
Barnes for the train.
6 triples in the game for Barnes, and she's hit 3 in a row.
Keep feeding her.
Rejected!
And a block by Goranova.
Back out.
Ines, coast to coast, coughs it up. She had the rim in her eyes and didn't really look to pass that ball. And then it's just sloppy play from both sides a little bit right now. I think the speed of the game is getting to both teams.
It is. And right now they need to slow it down a little bit, but I'm enjoying it. I'm going to say they need to slow it down just for the sake of saying it, but I'm enjoying it.
Nice touch passing, and it's ripped through by Bloom. No, correction, that's Scott.
Yeah, Kiara Scott down there.
And the foul's going to go against Example. Shears picks up her first. There is nobody with more than 2 fouls on Example. So they're doing a good job of staying out of foul trouble.
I think they need to.
That's it. In the corner, Goranova. And that's a foul off the ball.
Example came into this ball game with 3 reserves. One person got hurt, so now they only have 2. So they absolutely have to stay out of foul trouble.
For Example, number 12, Mia Zanare.
Mia Zanare comes back in. Currently the team captain on this Example national squad. Betson in the paint. Tiptoeing the line on 1 foot was Kira Scott, and she sets up Goranova for the triple.
It's raining threes, Mike.
It is indeed. Last night, it was a big storm.
I was asleep. I missed
Thankfully,
it. I think I woke
cleared
up
today, but all the rain came
drop
inside
in
the DMG
for Trinity
gymnasium. Yeah, nice bucket by Cheers. Only 5 points in the quarter. For Example, Prep, and I think we've got to give the DME defense their due. It's Barnes again! It's Barnes again!
That's number 7!
She shakes out her hands like they're on fire.
It is, Mike.
This is incredible. Ball thrown back to the top of the key. Trinity cheers.
Good job, Trinity cheers.
Yeah, Trinity cheers. The way that Example Prep came back and made it competitive in the first half was Trinity cheers taking over. He had 6 points, but 4 of those 6 points were late in the second quarter.
Barnes is looking for the ball over the top. They don't give it to her, they give it to Scott.
She steps through, whoop! And she loves that mid-range jumper.
Kiara Scott. My player of the game, but right now.
Well, pregame player of the
pre-game
game.
Pregame player of the game.
Right now, it's got to be Laura Barnes.
It has to be Laura Barnes. I can't deny it.
But again, let's go back and talk about the DME defense a little bit as
they let one slide, but it rims out.
That they have only allowed 7 points in the quarter. Foul on the way through. That's going to go against Gordon. And that'll be, I believe, Gordon's 3rd.
So in the third quarter, like we said, in the second quarter, the score is 54-31. We knew that DME might have a big night offensively, but they're actually exceeding our expectations right now.
Oh, it looks like it's going to be a 10. So Gordon gets a foul and also a technical foul. So now we have had a technical foul in every game today as Goranova is at the line and hits the first shot.
Number 42, Roxy White.
You have those days, Mike.
Yeah, and there was one for a small physical altercation. That was in the second game. But the ones in the first game and the third game must be for verbal altercations that we can't hear.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, because the first one I didn't hear. I was confused when they called a technical foul in the first game.
Well, the only reason I figured that was a technical foul is because everybody was getting out of the paint on a non-shooting foul. Barnes thought about pulling the trigger, but gives it off to Betson in the corner. They'll play post-game with Scott. Ball's tapped away from her, but it comes right back to Barnes. In the corner, Scott knocks it down. And it's a triple, her first of the game. Nice little hesitation move at the top of the key and a beautiful left-hand finish.
Trinity Cheers.
Cheers. 6 points in the quarter. She's up to 12 for the night. Already under a minute to go, third quarter, 59-33. DME with the lead thanks to the hot shooting from the outside. Barnes with the majority.
And she gave it up that time. She wanted to get Goranova into the ball game, into the feeling of the three game. She probably should have took it.
Seven threes in the third quarter for DME. Mm. Four of them by Laura Barnes.
Laura Barnes being a good teammate there.
That's another great drive by Samora Damon.
Ooh, that's all you can say when you see something like that.
I think we found the offensive style that's working. For example, prep.
Absolutely.
And one more technical fouls are going to be called.
On who?
As Coach Perry Bradford, for example, is.
And he's just as confused as we are.
What did I say? Yeah, we can hear him all the way over here. And it's going to put Goranova at the line again for more technical free throws.
And push this game out a little bit further. Let's see if she can get to 60. There we go.
60 points in the third quarter.
Mm-hmm. And we talked about it at the beginning of this game. The spread had to be 35 for it to be a running clock.
I don't think we're going to get that far, but we might. He misses the second one, but DME will still get possession. That's the first missed free throw of the game for DME.
Right. And it's the third quarter, so we still have a whole another quarter of basketball to go, but this one is flying by.
Timeout example with 4.7 seconds to go in the third quarter. Well, if you want more The League basketball action, we got you covered all weekend long. Tomorrow, Life Prep against Grind Prep, that's at 4 o'clock. 5:30 brings you Legacy against Example National. And from what we've seen, the defense of Legacy versus the offense of Example National should be a fun watch.
Right.
And then the nightcap, DME takes on Link Academy, who played very well against Grind Prep. Actually held them.
They held their own today.
Tied at halftime, and it kind of got away from them a little bit in the fourth quarter. But I was really impressed with Link today. We thought they would struggle before the game, but they came in and showed their own. Life Prep did struggle a little bit in the first half. Was down by 30 points at one point, but the final score, they only lost by 9. So even, yes, you can say that Legacy took their foot off the gas, took all the starters out, but they still played composed and they made their shots at the second half.
And they were competitive to the very end, which is something that you want to see.
Yeah. I would not be surprised if Life Prep steals a game here or there.
And especially at this juncture of the season, you want to make sure that your team is doing the right things and they are competitive, because you are in January, you're going into the bulk of your season. And you need to see who your team is right now.
DME will get the ball after the technical free throws. Goryanova. Like a, almost a soccer-esque overhand pass in. Quick trigger from the wing. It was right at the end of the third quarter. It had to go, but it did not. 60 points in three quarters. That's NBA-esque scoring frenzy. Because remember, the quarters are only 8 minutes.
8 minutes
in high school basketball.
But 8 minutes, they're getting it done. 60-35. We're going into our final quarter of the day. It's exciting. We got the fans at DME clapping. They're getting excited. I'm excited about the fourth quarter. I'm not going to lie to you.
Well, because remember what happened in game two. We thought Life Prep was dead and buried. Legacy took their foot off the gap. And Life came back and made a game of it.
And like we've been saying, Mikey Panazio, I don't think he's going to allow these players to take it off. I don't think so. I think they're going to keep doing the same things that they've been doing all game. And as you look around their bench right now, the starters look like they're about to go back into the ball game, even though they're up 30 points. Or actually, excuse me.
I'm going to give some praise right now to Trinity Chu of Example National.
Absolutely.
On the drive, she's been excellent.
Let's not forget about Roxy White.
Yeah. But cheers, right-hand finish, left-hand finish, hesitation moves at the top of the key to get defenders going the wrong way. It's been a clinic of how to drive a lane. Last season at Thornwood High School in South Holland, Illinois, 14.2 points, 4.5 rebounds, 2.5 assists, and led the team in scoring against in the loss to Montgomery Academy earlier this season. Trinity can play.
She's definitely doing a good job. And like I said, let's not forget about Roxy White. She's also the other player right now doing her thing for Example National.
White, 9 points. Cheers, 12 points.
Oh.
Talk about flying to the lane. Olivia Schmidt.
And looks like another Example National player has gotten hurt.
Well, that takes guts, right? If you're 5'5", I can empathize. I've always been the shortest player on whatever team I've been a part of.
Really?
Yes.
Me too.
Somehow I can't see that as I crane my neck to look up at you.
I've always been one of, but I played offensive line, so I've always been a shorter offensive lineman. I'm only 6'4". You know those guys started 6'8".
Schmidt at the lines. And my end of my point was I can emphasize with, you know, putting your body on the line, knowing you're going to take some contact, and putting yourself in that situation to either get the bucket or get to the line, and she did. Schmidt hits both free throws. 62-35.
Here's cheers for
three.
Bang!
Got it. Only the second three-point shot of the night hit by Example. The other one was from Roxy White. Goranova will let the clock run a little bit instead of taking a deep three. Dribble handoff. He gets it back.
Makes the pass.
Baseline drive, Barnes. Back out, Goranova. Double extra pass. They're just ringing it around the horn. This might be the longest possession of the night.
Ooh.
But it ends with another three for DME Academy. Olivia Schmidt starts the fourth quarter like DME has played the entire game. Raining shots from beyond the arc. Three off the mark from Damon. And that's going to be a blocking foul down low against Tabitha Betson. Tabitha Betson drew the foul. It's going to go against Example Prep.
Trinity
Cheers picks up her second. Betson. Out on top, Olivia Schmidt. Gets the dribble handoff from Betson. Runs into a baseline jumper too short. Example quickly runs the floor. Catch and shoot, top of the key. Leaves it short to Shania James.
We back flying.
Both teams back into that high flying, rapid fire offense. Goranova. Come on. Goranova with the no look pass to Scott for the easy bucket. Roxy White behind her head, reverse layup.
That's what I was telling you the last game, Mike. The reverse layup that I said that maybe, you know, dreaming I could thought I could do it. She did it excellent right there.
Look at Betson, the power forward, dribbling up the floor like a
She's been doing
guard.
That the last three possessions, man.
Now, DME just content to lengthen some of these possessions. Scott, floater, good. Woo. She's been hitting those all night.
I think
he's only, he's only missed one of them.
Good job by Kiara Scott.
That's a flying left-hand layup from Damon, no good.
Here we go.
DME on the horse again, but they'll just hold it up, let the sand drain through the hourglass.
She missed. She missed Barnes in the corner. Let's see if they can get it to her. Uh-oh.
They go to the other corner, catch and shoot. Finally, a three off the mark from DME, that time from Schmidt. But the hometown team gets a turnover.
And they're back at it again. And Barnes was trying to get back on her sweet spot.
You can see Coach Panaggio going slow, slow, slow as they come into the front court. No slow.
Bang!
No slow for DME. It's not in their dictionary. Gorianova, another triple.
Definitely not in the dictionary for DME tonight.
Already 12 points in the frame for DME. Another tough layup is missed by Trinity Cheers.
And they back at it again. 32-point spread right now.
Gotta get the front court. That was close.
It was almost close.
Close to a backcourt violation. Catch and shoot, turnaround three, no from Barnes. But DME gets the offensive rebound and a chance in the second possession.
There it is.
That's
again
a three from the moon for Gorianova. She hit that one from Belgium, or Bulgaria, excuse me.
Where's Bulgaria?
It is in northeastern Europe.
So you're just looking up all these countries, Mike. I see you.
I do research. That's my job.
I see you. I see you. Sri Lanka?
Off the mark. Yeah, we've had Sri Lanka and Bulgaria mentioned on the broadcast today.
Here we go.
Basketball is an international game.
Scott.
Off the rebound, misses the putback.
And you can tell she's a little frustrated with herself. Oh, big time
that's
foul
gonna be,
right
that's
there.
That's going to be a foul big against Gorianova. And that's her fourth.
But look
so
at the scoreboard.
She may be done for the day.
So what is the point score? 75-40.
So no running clock.
No running clock. I think that's usually what it is. I think it's a 35 points is what I remember.
Gorianova stays in the game despite picking up her fourth foul. But we do see Cheyenne Preston come back in. We'll have a timeout on the floor. And if tomorrow's menu didn't get you fired up, join us early on Saturday afternoon at 10:40 a.m. as Link Academy takes on Example National. 12:20 DME takes on Life Prep, and we'll end the weekend at 2 p.m. on Saturday with Legacy against Grind Prep. And that's after seeing all the teams play today, Legacy versus Grind, Sleeper could be game of the weekend.
You think so?
I do.
Really? Okay. So, I can go with that. Legacy versus Grind Academy might be the sleeper.
We thought this was going to be a heavyweight fight. Both teams throwing punches, getting back up off
it
the
It was
mat.
In the first few minutes of the game.
It was for maybe the first quarter and a half.
Right.
And then especially in the second half, DME.
Yeah, they just took
just
away
been
with
all
this
over Example Prep.
I like the fact that Example Prep is staying hydrated, though. Everybody on the sideline has a gallon of water.
Good pass. Corner triple, no good from Zanair. DME's got it done on the defensive side as well, contesting pretty much every shot. That's a drive and kick and shoot a three. That is good.
Ten dropped in.
Wow.
That's number eight.
Front iron, back iron, backboard, and in for Barnes.
Good job by Barnes today with the three-point shooting.
And you're right, 8 three-pointers in the game for Barnes. She saw the scouts here and said,
yeah,
it's my turn.
She's going to Notre Dame. She said, I'm going to Notre Dame. And
she already has 15 mid-major offers. She's only a sophomore, Laura
15.
Barnes.
Give me some of those, Mike.
I was not given the names of the schools. I was just told she has 15 mid-major offers. I was told that by Coach Mac Panacci.
But mid-major.
Mid-major.
So Notre Dame could be her first.
Power five.
Okay.
I mean, when you hit 8 threes in a game.
Right. They got the scout has to at least come give you a Gatorade after the game. And talk and say
into
something.
The post, and yeah, that's a foul against Reagan Chappelle, who was holding the shirt.
She had a lot of Roxy White. She had to deal with a lot. White. Chappelle's just getting in this ball game.
White 5'11", Chappelle 5'7". That's a pretty big height difference to deal with in the post. But you know who doesn't have a height disadvantage? Cheyenne Preston, as she blocks the White shot.
Yeah. And you could tell White on that last possession, she was getting a little aggressive because she knew she had the mismatch.
Palming violation against Goranova.
Goranova not happy with it. Look at her body reaction. She's like, oh no.
Now that's something I've seen called more at the college level this year than I may have seen ever.
Really?
And it must have been a focus for the referees coming into the year.
You know sometimes they do have their focus, and you know they have their meetings, Mike.
Yeah.
You know they have
their
meetings.
Well, and 2 years ago it was substitutions at different times, you know, when to allow substitutions, when not to allow substitutions. And this year it's probably palming violations. I've seen them called more frequently this year than any other. Gordon didn't take the three, stepped in for a long two, missed the mark. Just over 2 minutes to go.
And I like Preston coming in. She's playing pretty gritty coming in the ball game right now.
Oh, look.
Ball goes out of bounds.
Noelani Dunn still playing hard,
right.
Pressuring Goranova in the backcourt, almost forcing the turnover.
Down by 38.
Yeah.
With 2 minutes and 5 seconds left to go. You look. Hey, she looked over and saw the scout.
And that's, well, no. And that, as a coach, that's something you want to see from your play. Doesn't matter the game state. Doesn't matter what the score is. You want to see that competition.
And that's what I mean when she looked over and saw the scout, because that's what people look for at the next level. They look for you not to quit when you are down like this. They want to see what type of character you have.
Yeah. And I'm going to say we have not seen a lot of Ariana Williams in this game. She started, for example, national, but coming out after halftime, her right foot is in a boot, and she's been on the bench, and that's a big miss.
Yeah, she got hurt at the beginning of the game. It just went unnoticed.
Yeah, she's a commit to Penn State, shows it over Charlotte, Tennessee State, Western Michigan, Wichita State, Temple, and others.
Oh, there's Mike Panaggio walking across the court.
Yep. He hasn't lost his energy.
No.
It doesn't matter what the score is. It doesn't matter. There's 2 minutes left in a blowout game. He's going to coach the same way he's coached his entire career. DME to inbound. It's going to be Cheyenne Preston, the senior guard from Sanford. Getting it into Ines Goranova, the commit to Baylor. Lots of top programs getting talent from DME. Baylor, Mississippi State, Syracuse. Right at the end of the shot clock, a step back three is good for Goranova. Her third three of the fourth quarter. DME has hit 5 triples in the final frame. They're up to 81, highest score of anybody at this tournament so far today.
DME putting on an absolute show.
Their highest score of the season was in the first game. They beat TPLS Academy 84-33. They got a minute 15 left. Can they eclipse that? You know, all they need is one more three. Goranova trying to do it right now, leaves it short.
Yeah, that's going to fall short.
I'm sure those are the kind of things you're not thinking about.
And they didn't call a foul right there.
Yeah, Shania James looks at the official like, well, what do I need to do to get a call? Left-hand layup off the feed. That's Sophia Hickey, I believe. No, Hannah Kelly underneath.
Another foul that wasn't called. And that's the type of thing you don't call.
They're going to call the block. Taylor Girard, the 6'3 forward, another Bulgarian on this team. We're seeing some players that we haven't seen, but they still, like Girard hasn't played at all. She's got 3 Division I offers. Sophia Hickey really hasn't played, has a Division I offer. Hannah Kelly, a junior out of Australia, has interest from South Carolina and USC, hasn't really played tonight. And that is how deep this DME Academy is.
They are deep. They are deep, and they've been playing their hearts out this ball game. As you see some of the fans start to come to life and give them congratulations, and they're celebrating on the sideline. Right now, with 48.7 seconds left to go in the ball game, DME is leading 81 to 40.
Well, the great thing about these multi-day tournaments is whether you win or you lose, you've still got to play another game in 24 hours. And you have a different opponent, a different puzzle that needs to be solved for the coaching staff, and another chance to get out and show your skills for the players.
Right.
So you have to have a really short memory,
you do,
especially after a game like this, whether you win or you lose.
And I think right now the most important thing, for example, is to get out of this ball game with no more injuries. Let's just get the last 48 seconds done with, and maybe you can lick your wounds.
Head coach
Barry Bradford,
founder of Example National, was over at the scorer's table. Now he's chirping at the ref, and I think we might be about to see him teed up again. We'll see if there's an error with the timing or the scorebook. We're not sure.
At this point, the error is not 40 points.
Yeah. But you know how it is,
no,
right?
I know exactly.
When a coach gets hot about something, they want to have
but
their say.
But there have been two big contacts in the last two plays that weren't called.
And as a referee, it's sometimes important to let the coach have their say without retaliating.
Right.
Especially with 42 seconds left in a blowout game. We teed it up at the top of the broadcast as a heavyweight title fight. But only one team bought their boxing gloves tonight, and that team is DME, as Regan Chappelle gets DME up to 83 points. Easy bucket underneath after a pass. Roxy White finishes it off. Nice dish from Shania James.
Let's see if they go for the high. Oh,
now it's stolen off of Preston. White's going to get another easy bucket.
DME looks like they're going to just close this one out.
Now they throw it away again with 8 seconds left, and this can't be making Mr. Panaggio happy.
Not at all.
Two misses under the basket. Three players hit the ground like bowling pins with 0.1 seconds left. Tenth of a second to go. If you've watched us from beginning to end today, thank you for spending your Thursday afternoon with us.
Right. Thursday evening, Thursday
now,
afternoon.
Shot at the end of the clock is not good. It has not gotten off before the end of the game, even though it was banked in by Shania James. 83-44 is your final score. DME all over Example National.
Well, Mike, I had a good time.
It was a great day of basketball. We got two more days left. I won't be here tomorrow. I've got other obligations. I'll be back Sunday.
I'll be here tomorrow.
Enjoy Terrence talking you through more excellent basketball from the league. Give me a few seconds to tally some final scores, and then we can get out of here.
Guys, remember, thank you for watching this broadcast. This is the league. Mike is tallying the scores. You can catch us here tomorrow. Same time, same place. Once again, DME National beats Example National, 83-44.
There's a lot of threes to tally up here.
I see.
Please be patient.
I see. I'm being patient. I want to see the final three tally. Because Barnes was lighting it up tonight. And I think we ended off the evening with her having a total. I won't shoot numbers out at you right now. Go ahead.
I'll get you the numbers. Just
No, I didn't want to call a number that confuse you.
Oh, yeah, go for it, though. Go for it. All right, I've got the final scores tallied. First, for example, Prep. James had 4, Damon had 6, Cheers had 15, and White had 15. Mm. So they combined for 30 of the 44 example prep points. Mm. And for DME, this is going to take a while.
Okay.
Goryanova had 19, all of it in the second half, and she did not hit a two-point shot in the game. Mm. 5 triples, and the rest of the points gathered at the free throw line because of the technical fouls.
Okay. That's Goryanova.
That's Goryanova. Okay. Schmidt had 15, 3 threes. Beston had 3. Barnes had 26. Mm. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 three-pointers for Barnes. 4 of them in the third quarter alone. Mm. She's going to go back and want to watch that fourth quarter, or third quarter, over and over and over again. And Scott had 17. She only had 1 triple, but that step-in mid-range jump shot was deadly. She was hitting it all night.
Right.
That'll do it for us here from DME Sports Academy for day one of the league, presented by the National Athletic Association for Independent Schools. For Terrence, I'm Michael. We'll see you tomorrow, same time, same place, for more The League Basketball Action. Have a good night.